Excellency, Dr. Mrs. Claudiana Ibijoke-Sanwo-Olu, the wife of the Governor of Lagos State, Mr. Babajide Sanwo-Olu, was very grateful for this invite. Unfortunately, she's unable to make it due to earlier scheduled state functions. I therefore stand to represent her by observing the following protocols and delivering her speech. I would like to recognize and acknowledge the presence of the Honorable Minister from the Ministry of Mohammed Abubakar, ably represented by Dr. Andy Oka. We appreciate his leadership and support towards this cause. The Chairman AGM, PCO Olayemi, your commendable efforts towards the cause. The President, Pest Control Association, the DG National Agency for Food and Drug Administration Control, NAFDAC, Professor Mojisola Adeyeye, who is unable to make it today. We thank her for being a part of this noble cause and for standing out this year as an awardee. The Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Environment, Lagos, Mrs. Belinda Odeneye. Thank you. She's also unable to make it. Thank you for being a part and promoting the cause and also standing out as an awardee. The GMCEO, Lagos State Environmental Protection Agency, LASEPA, Dolapo Fashawe, who is unable to make it here also, but is ably read by a director in LASEPA, Mrs. Bededo Owa. Thank you for all your contributions in the industry. The Registrar of Environmental Health Officers Administration Control of Nigeria, Mohammed Bada. I believe, is he present? Baba Bada.
We appreciate your support, sir. To all other distinguished
awardees, thank you for your outstanding contributions to the cause. The guest speaker, Mr. Segiru Mohammed,
thank you for the speech that you delivered, and thank you for being a part of the cause. The distinguished invited guests, partners of the industry here present, thank you all for
audible efforts in the area of pest and vector control in the society. You will all agree with me that all pests, whether mosquitoes, rodents, and insects, can be a serious menace if left uncontrolled. It could also be morbidly detrimental to the health of our state and nation. We understand PECAN was founded in 1989 and has, in its 30 years of its existence, worked assiduously to improve professionalism in the practice of pest and vector control in Nigeria, and has thereby contributed in no small measure in the fight against pandemic diseases in our nation, such as malaria, Lassa fever, through vector control approaches. They have also been actively involved in fighting against the spread of the COVID-19 virus through community disinfections. We must note that these events are largely contributory to the success of all other containment measures already in place. The association has therefore become a major stakeholder and contributor to the environmental and public health policies and agenda of the nation. Worthy of note is the rollback malaria activities of the association. The theme of this event, Pest Management in Food Processing, Storage and Packaging Facilities, is quite apt, emphasizing the need to continue to provide novel solutions on how we best can prevent pest infestation in food processing, storage and packaging facilities in Lagos and in the nation at large. A cause to which I am also personally devoted to. I recall once visiting an eatery some years back, And as I was standing at the till about to make my order, a staff emerged from the kitchen area, and a foul smell of rodent presence hit me. But I suddenly became nauseous, and I had to leave without satisfying my hunger. As an entrepreneur, though, and I am very certain that I will be giving some of all the cleaning companies, some of the cleaning companies that I have seen, I'm quite impressed, quite a number of them, in the giving them a call to help to promote cleanliness in my own environment. Because together, we must all build Lagos State. Pest species are varied and can be any species of human that humans consider undesirable. That is, such organizations that reduce the availability, quality, or value of human resources wherever they are present, causing food decay and sometimes food poisoning in a lot of cases. We understand pest management is a means to reduce pest numbers to an acceptable threshold or an economically justifiable threshold, which refers to a situation where the application of control measures reduces pest numbers to a level below where additional applications would not be profitable, meaning additional cost of control should not exceed the benefits. Some say pest eradication, which is complete removal, is usually not a viable option. But I dare say it is a possible and much needed venture. Hence, methods of necessary pest management are typically categorized as in chemical, biological, cultural, physical, mechanical, or genetic. Of course, the experts here are certainly well-versed in the use of all these different methods. Pests are always drawn towards food, so large sites that manufacture huge amounts of food on a daily basis are perfect locations for pest activities. As a result, all food and drink companies must come together with all established government bodies to ensure that their plans are in place continually to limit pest infestation, because our health is our wealth. Finally, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, let me conclude by wishing the association a fruitful deliberation, and also congratulate all the 60 new awardees, new inductees here present, and thank all of the past awardees for standing out in their promotion of this noble cause. I thank you all very much for your attention. God bless us all.
We can do better for Lagos State. Please, a round of applause. Goodwill message courtesy the First Lady Lagos State, ably delivered by Mrs. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to recognize members of the press that are here to actually give us a live coverage of this event. However, I'd like to state that this event is being streamed live per can. A round of applause, please. So that it is on this note, I would like to invite to give us heat. We waited for it, and it is the time. I'm talking about the number one citizen of Pekan. Some of us already know who I'm talking about. It is the presidential address. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, please let's welcome the national president, Pekan, in the person of PCO Cole Williams. A round of applause, please. A round of applause as he comes up to share with us 2020 Mr. President, you're welcome, sir.
Up Pecan. Up Pecan. Up Pecan. I can't hear you at the back. I think our new convey my apologies to our guests and to all our members for the late start of this meeting and late arrival of my person and the representative of the minister. The flight was delayed and I had to be at the airport to pick him up. But I'm sure that you were well entertained and you, Dr. Segiro, must have you. So without wasting much time, I'll just go straight to my speech. The Honorable Minister of Environment, Dr. Mahmoud Abubakar, the DG, NAFDAC, Dr. Mrs. Mojisola Adeye, I would do a U-turn and start all over again. In protocol, you need to first of all recognize the First Lady of the State, who is the Chief Hostess of the State. So apologies, Madam. The First Lady of Lagos State, Dr. Mrs. Ibijoke Sanwo-Olu, ably represented. You're very welcome, ma'am. The Honorable Minister of Environment, Dr. Mohammed Mahmoud Abubakar, the DG NAFDAC, Dr. Mrs. Mojisola Adeyeye, the Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Environment, Mrs. Belinda Aderonke Odeneye, who is on her way here right now, the Registrar Ehorekon, Dr. Yakubu Baba, ably represented by the Deputy Registrar, Dr. Andy Uka, the General Manager, Lasepa, Dr. Dola Pofashawe, ably represented by one of the directors. Thank you very much, Madam. Dr. Timothy Olawale, DG NECA, who is a great partner, NECA Nigerian Employers Consultative Assembly, are very good partners of Pecan. Thank you, he's well represented here as well. Our dear Pecan past presidents, you're welcome. My able vice presidents, thanks for all the support. Members of ESCO and all members of Pecan, all other protocols duly observed. Pleasure to welcome you all and give glory to the Almighty who has made it possible for us to witness this remarkable day. The 31st Annual General Meeting of the Pest Control Association of Nigeria, PECAN. And I want to believe I'm speaking the minds of all the members of this great association. Though some people may not understand the peculiarity of this day, how important this day is to PECAN members. But a few of us that have witnessed the journey so far would attest to the fact that today is worth celebrating. Today, PECAN appears to be on the right track. We are now gaining public and government recognition, not only as a body of professionals, but also as an organization that upholds and defends rules and regulations by regulatory bodies. Many thanks to our regulatory bodies such as Environmental Health Officers Registration Council of Nigeria, EHORECON, State Ministry of Environment, and Lagos State Environmental Protection Agency in particular, and also our friends in the Environmental and Health Officers Association, EHOAN, for their constant support. Our successes as an association would not have been without the full support of these partners of ours. We thank you all. From the name, PECAN, that's the Pest Control Association of Nigeria. Of course, we are known for pest control related activities. Incidentally, everyone has the need to control pests. And of course, you could see that in the delivered speech from the representative of the First Lady, that we all are pest controllers in our own own position or wherever we find ourselves. For example, the act of taking your bath in the morning is inclined towards controlling some form of germ or pest. Of course, you know, pests are anything that could be vectors of diseases or anything that could cause any form of illness or illness, just to say that quite a number of illnesses are carried by vectors of diseases. Some may be of the opinion that the emergence of COVID-19 was what brought Pekan to existence. But little do they know that Pekan has been in existence since 1989. We actually celebrated our 30th anniversary last year, and we've been around for a while. The founding fathers of this great association, some of them well seated here, like Baba Ogunyadeka, some are already past heroes and they're resting in the Lord, had a vision to gather professionals and pest controllers under one umbrella towards achieving a safe and better environment through training and retraining of PCOs. Some of you may ask me what PCO is. It means a pest control operator. We are all PCOs in Pekan as we are operators. The present and past executive. President of Pekan can authoritatively tell you that all executive members that the journey is painstaking, and we thank God that the sky is the beginning, not the limit. The baton was passed over to us in 2008. Helped us record remarkable achievements, some of which has been highlighted in the. I would like to crave the indulgence of everyone here to join me as we and all members of Pekan for all their support to getting us to where we are today. These ladies and gentlemen have been very supportive to this administration. They are very dynamic and are core professionals in their own rights. And they have added so much value to the business of pest control management in Nigeria. I'm glad to inform you that the association has grown numerically at a very fast rate. And this year's 2020 AGM, we are inducting 60 new members. That is record breaking. Those coming in would add so much value, and we will also impart so much knowledge and professionalism in them. And I would like to use this medium to appeal to those whose applications have not yet been treated to bear with us. To ensure that no member admitted will fall short when it comes to professional respect whoever carries the Pekan authority. You know, to bring in them for certification by these regulatory bodies. So in closing, I want to congratulate every member of the person who has for for a successful year 2020. And I also congratulate our newly yet to all our invited guests and spouses. I can see quite a number of our spouses around here. I said big thank you for all your support and for coming as well. May the good Lord who made it possible for us to be here grant us journey mercies back to our various destinations. God bless Pekan. God bless Nigeria. Up Pekan. Up Pekan. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for PCO Kule Williams, National President, Pest Control Association of Nigeria. Sir, thank you very much. Anytime you see him, he comes up with energy, and that energy reflects in the corporate structure of Pekan. As long as this particular administration is concerned, moving forward, and we know that our best is yet to come. I'd like to leave the floor for my disc jockey, because this is a merged event. We'll have the very serious side of it, but of course, we know the year is coming to an end. Organizations have already designed their calendar for what 2021 will look like amidst the challenges of economic downturn, the fuel of crude, the price of crude, the challenges we have. But of course, the private sector is ready to take on 2021. Plus or minus, we know God is going to give us that year, and it's going to be a year of triumph. It's on that note, I'd like to leave the floor for the disc jockey for a couple of minutes while I put together the process for our guest lecturer to come on board. Ladies and gentlemen, DJ Uzi, take us a little bit to the 60s.
Was feeling right.
I'm coming out. I want the world to know. Got to let it show. I'm coming out. I want the world to know. Got to let it show.
There's a new me coming out, and I just have to live, and I wanna give. I'm completely positive. This time around, I am gonna do it like you never knew it. Oh, I'll make it through. The time has come for me to break out of the shell. I have to shout that I am coming out. I'm coming out.
I want the world to know.
Recognize
and show.
Live under love. So turn on the light, let it shine bright. Listen to this.
Jam it.
Reggae night. We come together when we're feeling right. Reggae night. And we'll be jamming till the morning light. Oh, then you reach the score.
When you love someone, it's natural, not maddening. And that's one thing I'm proud to say, I'm finding you. I'm so glad we reached an understanding. Now I know my heart is safe with you. So now my love to you, baby, I surrender. Yes, ready, I'm gonna be here tonight.
my life. Last night a DJ just saved my life, yeah.
Alright, DJ, who's ready? Thank you very much for reminding me of when my father was actually trying to get my mother. Couple of old schools there. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the President Pekan. It is now time for the academic part of today's gathering. I'd like to take a very short citation of our guest speaker for today. Ladies and gentlemen, captains of industry here present, our keynote speaker spent his entire career with the Nigerian government, rising through the ranks to become director in various directorates of NAFDAC. He recently retired as director of chemical evaluation and research. While in service, he served in various capacities as special assistant to the director general NAFDAC, national counterpart for International Atomic Energy Director, PODS. He participated actively in the introduction of the use of Raman spectrometer in NAFDAC with a well-known Troscan survey. Ladies and gentlemen, our guest speaker for today also supervised the introduction of electronic clearance known as e-clearance in port services and activities. It is on this note, I'd like to say that he is presently engaged as a principal partner with SmoothRaz Limited, a service company in regulatory analytical inspection and consultancy work. Ladies and gentlemen, members of the executive of Pekan, welcome our guest speaker for today, Segiru Momodu. A round of applause, please, as he comes forward.
Thank you, sir.
Excellency, the First Lady of Lagos State, Dr. Mrs. Ibijoke Sanwo-Olu, ably represented by Mrs. Edith Egube, the Honorable Minister of Environment, representatives of all federal ministries and parastatals, state ministries and parastatals represented here, the President, Mr. Kunle Williams, of the Pest Control Association of Nigeria, and all other distinguished members of the executive, inductees for today's ceremony, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, all other protocols duly observed. My name is Segiru, and I want to thank the President and members of the association for inviting me to be a guest lecturer at this very well distinguished and revered occasion. I'm glad to be here. I'm happy to be here also. Up Pekan. Thank you. Now, the topic of today is pest management in food processing, storage, and packaging facilities. As we know, the issue of pest management is a major problem for both stored products and products that we use on a daily basis. Virtually everywhere we go, in every situation, pests constitute a nuisance. And if you don't control pests very well, you end up with so much losses and bad business. Next slide. Should hold it. Okay. Well, please. Next slide, please. What's happening? So So as I said, pest management can be examined from the underlying major elements of food safety and quality management. As many of you are aware, pests are mainly associated with food. And so there are so many rules and regulations governing food management in the country and are controlled by different federal and state government agencies. So we are going to look at some of these parameters which we use to control food and from there look at pest management. So pest management can be from the aligned major elements of food safety and quality management. There are current good metabolism factors, CGMP we call it, which embodies everything that has to do with food control. Then you have, as part of this good management practice, a very major part called hazard analysis and critical control point, which is very, very, very important. Hazard analysis and critical control point, it's a system where you have to look at what hazards are in the system so that you can control them effectively. The other one is quality management system, which gives you options of what to do and ensure good management. Then you have risk analysis and risk-based preventive controls, which comes from the basis of risk assessment. Risk assessment or risk analysis generally, we are going to talk about it later. You look at risk analysis and risk-based preventive controls of human food. Then, under this, you need to have a food safety plan, a hazard analysis and preventive controls. Last but not the least is integrated pest management, which embodies or incorporates all what you do about pest control. Now, GMP principles. Because of time, I will not want to go into the details, but the GMP principles are at length and takes care of everything when it comes to managing food control in industries. But the very areas of emphasis will be here are hazard analysis and critical control point, which is a part of quality control. This is what the main area where pest control resides in. The other one is environmental sanitation and personal hygiene, where the issue of pests is exhaustively discussed. Next slide. So, as I mentioned, the hazard analysis and critical control point, we need to look at critical control points. In a HACCP assessment of a food environment, you talk of HACCP as a systematic approach to identification, evaluation, and control of food safety hazards based on the following 7 principles. I don't want to go into all the details because of time, but the main areas where you have to look to in case of pest control is determination of the critical control points and establishing critical limits. For example, you have to know what areas of your factory pests will come into and how to restrict them. So those areas you are going to look at are called critical control points and then establishment of critical limits. So the 7 principles, you take time to read them, but the most critical as far as pest control are these 2. Next slide. Environmental sanitation and pest control. These are the rules. Pests must not be allowed in any area of a food plant. Effective measures must be taken to exclude pests from the manufacturing, processing, packaging, and holding areas, and to protect against the contamination of the food on the premises by pests. So, this is the major area of pest control. But one thing that is very important, which Mr. Wollen would not want to hear, is this particular one. The use of pesticides to control pests in the plant is permitted only under precautions and restrictions that will protect against the contamination of food, food contact surfaces, and food packaging materials. So, control of pests, but use of pesticides is very much restricted because of the hazards involved. So, if you are going to control pests, there must be some special provisions and permission before you can use pesticides in the control industry. Now, the other one is the quality management system, ISO 901215. Quality management system is a sort of procedure that allows you to do good management and takes care of so many things in a very organized manner so that you consistently get good results. So if you ensure